Okay, good morning everyone. Today we'll discuss some problems. Take this problem. A synchronous motor is receiving 10 megawatt of power at 0.8 power factor lagging at 6 kilovolt. And LG fault, so single line to ground fault, takes place at the middle point of the transmission line as shown in the figure. Find the fault current, the rating of the generator, motor and transformer are as under. So generator rating is given 20 MVA, 11 kV, X1 is 0.2 per unit, X2 is 0.1 per unit and X0 is 0.1 per unit. And for transformer, 18 MVA. So primary 11.5, that is star connection, secondary also 13.5 kV star connection, and X is given 0.1 per unit. For transmission line, X1 and X2 both are equal 5 ohm, X0 is given 10 ohm, and transformer 2 15 MVA, primary 6.9 kV and secondary is 34.5 kV. 34.5 kV is the primary and 6.9 is the secondary. Okay, and X is 0.1 per unit. And motor value 15 MVA, 6.9 kV. And X1 is equal to 0.2 and X2 is equal to, X0 is equal to 0.1 per unit. So take this problem. And solution. So mark all the voltages and parameters. So generator is 20 MVA. Oh, this color is not visible. So 20 MVA, 11 kV is there, and X1 is 0.2 per unit, and X2 is also 0.1, and X0 is also 0.1 per unit. That is for generator. For transformer, 18 MVA, transformer 1. 11.5 kV star connection, and second one is 18 kV, 11.5 kV, and secondary is 34.5 kV. So here also 34.5 kV, here is 6.9 kV, and transmission line values are given, that is 5 ohm and 10 ohm. This is X1 and X2 is 5 ohm and X0 is 10 ohm. For transformer, X is 0.1 per unit. This is for all positive and negative and zero sequence. For all, it is 0.1 per unit. For transformer 2 also, it is 0.1 per unit. For motor, 15 MVA. So is it visible what I am writing?
Yes, sir, visible, sir.
Okay, 15 MVA, so 6.9 kV, sorry, 6.9 kV. X1 is 0.2 per unit, and X2 and X0 is 0.1 per unit. So these are the parameters. So we can solve this. So take base values. Solution. What are the base values? Base values, that is base MVA is taken as 20 MVA. So let's choose the base on the, we need to choose, that is we will choose generator base. So MVA base is equal to, that is new base, that is equal to 20 MVA, that is on generator side. So voltage levels, base voltage, KV base, new is equal to 11 KV on generator. So MVA base new, it is common for all the section, but for KV base we need to calculate for transmission line. KV base for transmission line, it will be 11 KV multiplied by HT 34.5 divided by LT 11.5 KV. So this will give us 33. So here 11.5 is there, LT side, HT side is 34.5 is there. So we will get 33 KV. And base voltage on motor side, 33 into 6.9 KV divided by 34.5 KV. So motor side 6.9 KV is there, LT, HT is 33, that is the KV base we have calculated, that is 33 here. Okay, 33 into 6.9 divided by 34.5 HT side. So this will give 6.6 KV. This is the base value for motor. So therefore, sequence reactance for transformer, it is taken as 11 KV. So for both the transformer, so one transformer T1, for T1 it is 11 KV, for T2 we will consider, that is 6.6 KV. Okay, so these are the base values. So now you need to calculate sequence reactance on generator side. So that is given by X1 is equal to, so what is the generator rating, that is X1 is given here. So X1 is equal to 0.2, right? So therefore, write X1 is equal to 0.2 into base, new base MVA is also 20, old base MVA is also 20, and new base voltage 11 and old base voltage 11, so both square. So we have taken generator base voltage, generator voltage is as a base voltage, therefore whatever the reactance present in the generator, it will remain same. So this will become 0.2 per unit only, x1. Similarly, x2 and x0, both we have taken as 0.1. So this is also remains as 0.1 per unit. Okay. So generator side, base is taken. So new base and old base, both will be equal. Okay. So next, sequence reactance on transformer side. Sequence reactance on transformer 1, transformer T1. So in this case, he has given only one reactance. So this is common, 0.1 is common for T1 is equal to 0.1, X1 is 0.1 per unit, means so X1, X2, X0 all are equal here. X1 is equal to X2 is equal to X0 is equal to 0.1 per unit, that is given. So we need to calculate the new value. So 0.1 into, so new base is 20, and what is the old base of transformer 1? 18 MVA. So 18. And what is the old base of the transformer? So voltage, that is 11.5 kV. Divided by new base is 11 square. So calculate it. So what is the value of reactance of transformer T1? How much you got? How much you got, Rajshekar? Calculate this. 0.1 into 20 by 18 into 11.5 square by 11 square. What is the value?
0.121, sir.
0.12 per unit. Okay. Right. So similarly, sequence reactance of transmission line, we need to calculate. Our transmission line. So in transmission line, so x1 is equal to, x2 is equal to, X naught, sorry, X2 is equal to X1, X1 is equal to X2 is equal to same, both are same. How much it is? That is given transmission 5 ohm and X naught is given as 10 ohm. Okay, so both are old values. You need to convert this 5 ohm into MVA base by KV base square. So MVA base, new base is 20 and KV new base on transmission line is 33 square. You will get 0.092 per unit. Similarly for X0 is equal to 10 ohm into 20 by 33 square. How much you got? 0.184 per unit. So similarly, calculate for sequence reactance of transformer 2. So in this case, X1 is equal to X2 is equal to X0. That is 0.1 per unit. Same thing. In this case, 0.1 into new base is 20. Old base for transformer 2. So what is the transformer 2? 15 MVA, right? 15 MVA multiplied by old base voltage 6.9 kV New base voltage is 6.6 kV on transformer 2. 6.9 is the new base, say old base, 6.9 old base. So after we have calculated, so we will get 6.6, that is the new base. So what is the transformer 2 value, X value? You will get 0.146 per unit. Similarly, calculate for motor. You need to calculate for motor X1 and X2 and X0 are equal. X2 and X0 is equal to 0.1, X1 is 0.2. In this case, 0.2 into 20 by 15 into 6.9 by 6.6 square. Similarly, 0.1 into 20 by 15 into 6.9 by 6.6 square. So both squares. So X1 is, you will get 0.29 per unit. X2 is equal to 0.145 per unit. So these calculations are over. So the conversion of per unit values, that is the new values. So after this, you write all the values, whatever you get, in one side. So I will write for generator what we have get: X1 new value, X2 and X0, X1 0.2 per unit, 0.1 and 0.1. Similarly, transformer one, X1, X2 and X0 all are equal to 0.12 per unit. So next is transmission line. Transmission line X1 and X2 we got as 0.092 per unit, and X0 we got as 0.184 per unit. So for transmission line transformer 2, so transformer 2 point X1, X2 and X0 we got as 0.146 per unit. And for motor, right here only, for motor X1 is equal to 0.29, X2 and X0 equal to 0.145 per unit. Okay, now we need to draw the positive sequence network for this. Positive sequence network. So positive sequence network is the network including voltage source with reactance. So voltage source EG and generator reactance X1 we need to write now. What is X1 new value? That is equal to 0.2. That is, put J 0.2. Okay. So similarly, after generator, we have transformer 1. Transformer 1 reactance, that is J 0.12 per unit. So then we have a transmission line. Transmission line X1, that is 0.092 is there. So the fault is occurred at the middle point. So we got the fault. Hence, this reactance of transmission line will split into two parts. So therefore, I will write this into split into two parts. So middle exactly the fault is occur. Okay, so therefore this total reactance of transmission line 0.092 divided by 2, so we'll get J0.046 and J0.046. Is it clear? The total reactance I will divide because the fault is on the middle of the transmission line. So this total reactance is 0.092. So that is I will divide by 2 and middle exactly fault is occur. So therefore 0.046 and J0.046. So then transformer 2 is J0.146. Then for motor 0.29, J0.29, and motor E, EMF, EM positive and negative. This is the reference bus, and voltage that is VTH we need to calculate, that is VTH across the point F, that is the fault voltage. We need to find out VTH here. So VTH and ZTH, this is called as ZFM. So Z from the fault point. So now we need to calculate VTH. So this VTH and also ZTH. All of you following this?
Yes, sir.
So to find the voltage at the fault point now. So that is called as VTH. So we require current drawn by the motor. That is equal to IM. So current drawn by the motor, that is given 10 mega watt, right? In the problem he has given 10 mega watt. So 10 into 10 raised to 6 divided by root 3 VL. So root 3 VL is motor voltage. 6 kV is the motor rating is given. Motor 10 megawatt and 6 kV and 0.8 power factor lagging, that is given. According to this, we will calculate the motor current. So root 3 into, so 6 kV, 6 into 10 raised to 3 multiplied by 0.8. And if you want angle, so cos of 0.8 is the angle is there. So cos inverse, take minus because of lagging. So cos inverse of 0.8. So calculate this, you will get motor current IM. That is 1202.8 at an angle minus 36.86, that is ampere. So this is your motor current. Once you know the motor current flowing, multiplied by this, so you convert this whatever the motor current is there in terms of base value. So therefore IM base is equal to, so new base, that is 20 MVA, 20 into 10 raised to 6 divided by root 3 into new base value is 6.6 kV, 10 raised to 3. Okay, so this is our actual value, 10 megawatt, 6 kV and 0.8 power factor. So in this case, base values for motor and generator, So we have calculated for base value for motor. So new value is 20 MVA by 6.6 kV. To root 3, we will get 1749.55 ampere. So now we have actual value and we have base value. So actual value of motor current and base value of motor current. So calculate per unit. Im per unit is equal to actual value by base value. Actual value 1202.8 and base value is 1749.55 at an angle minus 36.86 degree. So how much you got? Im per unit is equal to 0.687 at an angle minus 36.86 per unit. So this is your motor current in terms of per unit. And also calculate voltage across the motor. So Vm per unit. Vm per unit is equal to, so actual value by base value. So actual value is 6, base value is 6.6. So therefore 6 by 6.6 kV. This is equal to 0.909 at an angle 0 per unit. So now, so we need to calculate VTH now. VTH is equal to Vm plus Im into ZFM. So look into the diagram. So we want to find out this VTH. This VTH is equal to voltage across the motor, that is Vm, plus current flowing through this circuit, that is Im. Current flowing through this Im into ZFM. So what is ZFM? These two impedances. Okay, so this will give the VTH. This voltage plus this voltage drop, this will give the VTH voltage. Is it clear? So therefore we can write it as, so Vm we got 0.909 plus Im we have 0.687 at an angle minus 36.86 multiplied by ZFM 0.192 at an angle 90 degree, because J is 90, both in common there is a J is there, 0.046, 0.146, this will use 0.9, 0.192, add these two, 0.192 and J is common, so J means 90 degree. So calculate the value of VTH. How much we got? So we will get 0.994 at an angle 6.1 degree per unit. So this is your VTH. All of you got the answer? All of you getting the answer? Previous answers? As same as whatever I am doing here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Anybody having got the different answers? So now we need to find out ZTH. For so now we need to find out Z1TH, because it is the positive sequence represented by Z1TH, negative sequence represented by Z2TH. Okay, like that. So therefore, so find out Z1TH. So Thevenin impedance, Z28 means Thevenin impedance seen from the point F. From point F, that is the fault point. From the fault point, so what is Z1th? So look into the diagram. Okay, so look into the diagram. Z1th from the point F. So from the point F, what happens? So current is flowing like this. So then these things and these things will are in parallel. Okay, whenever we are doing Z1th, so we need to short the all the voltage sources. So then the circuit will be like this. So fault point is here. Circuit is like this. This is the fault point. So therefore, these three are in series. These three are in series. Then these things are in parallel. Okay. So 0.2, 0.12, and 0.046 are in series. Similarly, 0.046, 0.146, and 0.29. So these are in series. So these two series combinations are in parallel now. Okay. So we can write it as ZTH is equal to J is common in all the sides. So first one is 0.2 plus 0.12 plus 0.046. This combination is parallel with point 046 plus 0.146 plus 0.29. So this is called as Z1th. So calculate this. J is common. How much you got Z1th? So 0.2, 0.12 and 0.046, that is 0.366 parallel with, so add these things you will get 0.482. J is there. So these two are in parallel, means 0.366 into 0.482 divided by 0.366 plus 0.482. So what is the value? So this is J 0.208 per minute. So this is called as Z1th. Okay. So from the positive sequence network, we found VTH as well as Z1th. Right. So now draw negative sequence network. So negative sequence network is similar to the positive sequence network, but only change is the voltage sources are shorted. Okay, so that is called as your negative sequence network. And for generator, only the reactance value is change. I will draw negative sequence network. So generator, that is right, x2 value is J 0.1, and for transformer is common J 0.12, and transmission line again split into two part because fault is occurred in between that, so this will becomes J 0.046, this is J 0.046. And transformer 2, J 0.146. Motor, J 0.145. Okay. So find out Z2TH. So similar way, so these three are in series and these three are in series, both are parallel. So take J common. So 0.1 plus 0.12 plus 0.046 parallel with 0.046 plus 0.146 plus 0.145. So calculate Z2TH. How much it is? Z2TH. So this one is 0.266 is parallel with 0.337. J is there. Z2TH will become 0.266 into 0.337 divided by 0.266 plus 0.337. We will get J 0.149 per unit, right? This is called as Z2TH. All of you got this answer?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now we need to draw zero sequence network. So zero sequence network for generator, transformer, transmission line split into two part, and transformer two and motor. X naught for transform generator, it is J0.1, and transformer J0.12, transmission line J0.092 and J0.092. So because for X naught for transmission line is 0.184 per unit. So this was changed here from the previous case. Previous 0.0 we have divided into 0.046, right? But in this case, X naught for transmission line, that is calculated as 0.184. So divide 0.184 divided by 2. So 0.092 and 0.092, because fault is occurred here. Middle point, and transformer 2 J0.146, and motor X naught for motor J0.145. So same thing, Z naught TH we need to calculate. Calculate J into 0.1 plus 0.12 plus 0.092 parallel with 0.092 plus 0.146 plus 0.145. Z0TH is equal to, you will get J 0.172 per unit. So we got VTH and Z1TH, Z2TH and Z0TH, right? So now we can write combined sequence network. Combined sequence network. By using this, I will write combined sequence network, interconnection of sequence network. First I will write VTH value. What is VTH we got? 0.994 at an angle 6.1 degree volt, 0.9 degree, that is in terms of per unit, right? Not volt, it is in terms of per unit. Similarly, Z1TH, so these two are used for uniform positive sequence network. So Z1TH we got J 0.208 per unit. From negative sequence network we got Z2TH, that is equal to J 0.149 per unit. And zero sequence network we got Z0TH, that is equal to J 0.172 per unit. Right? So now we will draw the for LG fault, single line to ground fault circuit. So single line to ground fault circuit is, this is BTH, this is Z1TH, this is in series with negative sequence network, Z2TH, series with Z0TH. Write the value of VTH. VTH is 0.994 at an angle 6.1 degree per unit. Z1TH is 0.208 J per unit. Z2TH 0.149 per unit. And Z0 is J 0.172 per unit. And current flowing here, this is called as IA1. This is called as IA2 and this is called as IA0. So this is the interconnection of sequence network. Okay. So in this case, series circuit, therefore IA1 is equal to IA2 is equal to IA0, right? So this is equal to what? VTH divided by Z1 plus Z2 plus Z0, Z1TH plus Z2TH plus Z0TH, right? So we know that VTH and Z values, so directly you can calculate IA0 or IA1 or IA2. So VTH is 0.994 at an angle 6.1 divided by J common in all the case. So write Z1TH is 0.208 plus J 0.149 plus 0.172. So calculate, that is equal to IA0 is equal to, you will get how much you got? 1.88 at an angle minus 83.9 degree. Once you got the IA0, you can find out the fault current. So IF is equal to 3 times of IA0, right? So magnitude you want, so take only magnitude. So IF is equal to 3 times of 1.88. So this is equal to fault current is equal to 5.64 per minute. So I want fault current in terms of actual value. This is in per unit. So therefore, IF in per unit multiplied by ITL base value. So what is ITL means? Transmission line base value. So for this, calculate this IF per unit is 5.64 multiplied by, so current of transmission line is, new base value is 20 MVA, 20 into 10 raised to 6 divided by root 3 into 33 kV line, 33 into 10 raised to 3. So this will use IF per unit, that is IF actual value is equal to 1973.49 ampere. This is the actual value of fault current in the middle point of the transmission line. This is in terms of per unit we have calculated. So converting per unit into the actual value, actual fault value. Is it clear? So this seems the problem is very lengthy. So it will take 1 hour to calculate. Okay. So keep on practicing this, these type of problems. So any doubt regarding this problem? All of you got the answers? Same answers?
Yes, sir.
Vismaya, got the answer?
Yes, sir.
So once again, I will revise this problem in brief. So first we have converting all the sequence reactances in terms of new base, and also converting into the per unit, new per unit values. After this, so we will write all the new per unit values one side, and we will write positive sequence network. From this, we will calculate the VTH. VTH can be calculating by the voltage drop across motor and voltage drop across the ZFM. So therefore, we will get VTH. So that can be calculated by IM per unit. So IM per unit and IM base. So both we can finally we will find out IM per unit by calculating IM actual and IM base value. So then we will calculate the VTH. So then draw the negative sequence network. Positive sequence network, that is we need to calculate Z1TH, that is VTH and ZTH. So this Z1TH is the Thevenin impedance, equivalent impedance. So after this, we have calculated negative sequence network, draw the negative sequence network, you will get Z2TH. So similarly, draw zero sequence network and find out Z0TH. Finally, you calculate for single line to ground fault, draw the sequence network. So from that sequence network, so we can calculate IA naught by using the equation. So then IF is equal to 3 times of IA naught. So that is we got IF is equal to 5.64. So convert per unit into actual value. So this will use 1973.49 ampere. This is the fault current when single line to ground fault occur on the given transmission line. Okay, is it clear? Okay, shall we close the class? Anybody having doubt? Okay, you practice some more problems, whatever have not done in the class. So remaining problems in the textbook, you solve it in your home. So that is taken as a homework. Okay, so we will conclude the class. Okay, thank you very much.